All right, moving on to another big event. Shriners Fest is coming up later this week along the Evansville Riverfront. A lot going on, including the big air show. Here with us with a preview of Shriners Fest is co-chair Donnie Moser. And Donnie, I know you guys are really excited for this event that happens each and every year. Now just a few days away, all of this planning kind of coming to a head, right?
It is coming together. We're putting things together. We started yesterday on Father's Day, putting things together and putting fencing up and staging up. Just getting ready, and it's just going to keep rolling from day to day until showtime on Thursday.
Downtown Evansville is already kind of looking a little different with the roads being closed, kind of getting prepared for that. I mean, what about Shriners Fest to you makes it so special this year in particular?
We are honoring our first responders, our firefighters, mm-hmm. our police department. Kind of like the theme we had last year, we did the tribute to the veterans. This year, we're tributing our local people, our EFD, our first responders, our EMS. Just paying a big tribute to them.
I know the tribute to the veterans last year was a lot of people really appreciated that. And that was a really special event. And you said the state fire marshal is going to come down for this too, right?
Yes, he will be down Thursday for our opening ceremonies and just be down with us for the day. It's quite an honor to have him down here.
Yeah, and we talk about the air show too. I think that's one of the things, like we've talked about, people will see and hear. Let's explain the logistics of the air show and what all we're going to be seeing this year.
Well, the logistics of the air show actually started way back in the beginning of the year, so usually right around November.
Wow.
And then we keep planning and getting our act signed and putting it all together and then getting everybody here on Thursday.
So who do you think we're going to be seeing here? What types of planes for people who love this air show each and every year? What are they going to be seeing?
We're going to see some acrobatics. We're going to see some sky riders. We're going to see some vintage military planes. None of the big jets like we're used to in the, really lighting up the sky, but there will be some rumble in the sky.
No doubt about that. I'm sure a lot of these planes with the acrobatics that go straight in the air and tumble down and things
yes.
like that. I mean, it's always a sight to see. If somebody wants to go to Shriners Fest this year, how would they do that? What's the event expected to be like?
Well, buttons are still on sale. They're on sale till Wednesday at $10 a button. Mm-hmm. They will be available online at ShrinersFest.com up until Friday at 1 o'clock for the $10. And after that 1 o'clock hour on Friday, they go to $15 at the gate.
It's obviously an extremely busy schedule. Things begin on Thursday and they go all the way through Saturday or Sunday?
They actually go through Sunday at 5 o'clock.
Okay. And for anybody who wants to learn more information about how they can be a part of this, we'll put some info on tristatehomepage.com. But what's the website they can go to as well?
Shrinersfest.com. We'll get them all the information they need as far as our schedule, how to get buttons, even how to volunteer.
Awesome. So Donnie's here with, I like your hat, by the way. Gibson County on there. Absolutely, absolutely love it. And we love the Shriners Fest each and every year. Ron, weather-wise, these planes may have to dodge some rain, but it's nothing people aren't used to this time of year. And we talked about that 20%. I think that's on Thursday for the opening ceremonies, right? It's the lowest we'll see.
But Friday.